Hello friends, welcome to TechStudyCell. In this video, we'll make a IoT-based home automation project using the NodeMCU and the new Blynk IoT platform to control 4 appliances through internet and from the manual switches. And with this project, if there is no Wi-Fi, still you can control the appliances manually with switches or push buttons. To make this project, you just need a NodeMCU and a relay module, so you don't need any custom designed PCB for this project. And during the video, I will share the circuit diagram and explain the code for this project. So after watching the complete video, you can easily make this project for your home. Now before going to the details, let me show you how this project works. If the NodeMCU connected with the Wi-Fi, then this blue LED will blink very slowly, which indicate now I can control the appliances from the Blynk IoT app. And you can see I can easily control these lamps from the Blynk IoT app. Now let me control these appliances from the manual switches, and you can monitor the real-time feedback in the Blynk IoT app. Now let me turn off the Wi-Fi and show you how this works without internet. After turning off the Wi-Fi, you can see this LED is blinking rapidly, which indicate now NodeMCU is not connected with the Blynk server. Still, I can control the appliances from these manual switches, but I cannot monitor the real-time feedback in the Blynk IoT app as the NodeMCU is not connected with the Blynk cloud. So this is a very useful IoT-based home automation project, and I will highly recommend you to watch the complete video as I have explained all the steps in details. So let's get started. These are the components required for this project. You need a NodeMCU, a 4-channel relay module. Now if you want to control 8-channel relay module, then I will suggest you to use ESP32 instead of NodeMCU. And to control the appliances manually, you can use switches or push buttons. Now we have to connect all these components as per this circuit diagram. In the circuit, you can see I have given the 5-volt supply to NodeMCU and the relay module. And these switches are connected across the GPIO pin and the ground pin. Now if you use push button, then you can refer this circuit. You just have to connect the push button instead of switches. And as I said, for 8-channel relay module, you have to use ESP32. You can refer this circuit for that. And again, if you want to use switches, then connect the switches across the GPIO pin and the ground pin. And this is a 220 volt circuit, so please take proper safety precaution while connecting these appliances with the relay module. As you can see, there are a lot of connections, so to make the circuit compact, I have designed a PCB for this project. But as I said, you can also make this project without using any custom designed PCB. Still, if you want to get this custom designed PCB, then download the GABA file from the video description and order it from the JLC PCB. You can order any custom designed PCB from JLC PCB with 3 simple steps. First, upload the GABA file. Then select the parameter like quantity, PCB masking color, then place the order. If you select faster delivery service, then you will get the PCB within a week. And as you can see, the quality of the PCB is very premium in this affordable price range. So you can always try JLC PCB for your any custom design PCB project. Now these are the components required for the PCB. Now I will quickly solder all the component on the PCB. Now let me connect the NodeMCU with the PCB. Before uploading the code, you have to configure the Blynk cloud account. For that, you have to visit this page. Here you can create a new Blynk cloud account. I already have an account, so let me log into it. And in my previous video, I have already explained how to create Blynk cloud account, then how to create a template. I have already created this template in my previous video. Then how to create data stream. Here I have added 4 data stream to control 4 relay. Then I have configured the web dashboard. And here again, I have added 4 switch visit to control 4 relays. In my previous video, I have explained all this process step by step, so you can easily do that. Please refer my previous video, link is in description and as well as the I button. These are the codes for this project. Now if you use switch, then you have to refer this code. Here I am going to upload the code for push button. So let me open this code. So this is the code for the push button. You can easily download this code from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article link given in the description, then you can download the code from these two buttons. So if you use switch, then click here to download the code for switch, or for the push button you have to click on this button. After downloading the code, first you have to install the ESP8266 board. Then you need just Blynk libraries. I have used this version. Then you have to mention the template ID and device name. For that you have to go to the Blynk cloud account, and if I go to template, then I will use this template for this project, and for each template you will get a template ID and device name. So I will click here to copy this, then I will go to the Arduino IDE, and here I have to paste it. Now if you refer the same circuit, then after doing these changes you can directly upload the code to NodeMCU. For that you have to go to tools, select the NodeMCU 1.0 board, then select the proper port, then hit the upload button. And these are the GPIO pins I have used for this project. For Wi-Fi indicator I am using D0 pin. So in the setting you can see I have mentioned the D0 pin, which is GPIO 16, and for this board button pin I have mentioned D8 or GPIO 15. Now let me go to the config mode.h header file. Now if I go to the last line of this header file, here you can see I have commented this line. So to control appliances without internet, you have to comment this line, which I have already done. But there is small limitation that if you comment this line, then NodeMCU will not automatically reconnect with the Wi-Fi if the Wi-Fi comes back. In that case, you have to manually press the reset button of the NodeMCU. Then NodeMCU will reconnect with the Wi-Fi. So this is up to you. If you uncomment this line, the NodeMCU will automatically reconnect with the Wi-Fi, but you cannot control the appliances without internet. And if you comment this line, then NodeMCU will not automatically reconnect. You have to press the reset button, but you can control the appliances without internet. And I have also modified the BlynkEdgent.h header file. So here you can see I have added this manual control function to control appliances manually. So these are the changes I have made in this code. You can always modify this code as per your requirement. Now if you want the code for the 8 channel relay module, then please let me know in the comment section, then I will also upload that code in the same article. To configure the mobile dashboard, first you have to search for the Blynk IoT app. Now I have to tap on open, then I have to log in to the Blynk cloud account, then I have to tap on this developer mode, and here I am using this template, so I have to tap on the template. So here I have to add widget, so again I will tap on this three dash icon and add four button to control four relays. After that tap on first button, then select the data stream switch 1, as I will control relay 1 from this button, then mode will be switch, then exit from this button. Now again tap on the next button and select the data stream 2 to control relay 2, and again mode will be switch, now exit from that button. In a similar way you have to configure 4 button to control 4 relays. After configuring all the widgets, I have to exit from this developer mode. Now I will tap on add new device and tap on the connect to Wi-Fi. Now I will tap on ready. During this time this LED should blink. Now I will tap on this hotspot Blynk NodeMCU. Then you have to select the Wi-Fi network which you want to use, then accordingly enter the password for that Wi-Fi network. After that tap on continue. Now it will upload the Wi-Fi credential to the NodeMCU. After that tap on continue, then tap on setup as new, done. After that, tap on finish and exit. After the NodeMCU connects with the Wi-Fi LED will blink very slowly. So now I can control the relays from the Blynk IoT app, and I can also monitor the real-time feedback in the Blynk IoT app if I control the appliances from the push button or switches. Now let me connect the appliances with this relay module as per this circuit diagram. As you can see, I have connected these four lamps with the relay module as per the circuit. Now let me turn on the supply. You have to wait for some time. During this time, the NodeMCU will automatically connect with the Wi-Fi. Now if the Wi-Fi connected, then LED will blink slowly. So now I can control it from the Blynk IoT app, and I can also control it manually and monitor the real-time feedback in the Blynk app. As you can see, I can monitor the real-time feedback in the Blynk app. Now let me turn off the Wi-Fi and show you how it works without internet. After turning off the Wi-Fi, I can only control the appliances manually from this push button or switches. You cannot monitor the real-time feedback in the Blynk app as Wi-Fi is not connected. Now let me turn on the Wi-Fi again. After turning on the Wi-Fi, the NodeMCU will not automatically reconnect with the Wi-Fi. I have to press the reset button, and then again it may take 30 seconds to reconnect with the Wi-Fi, and you can see it fetched the previous state from the Blynk server, and accordingly all the lamp turns on. If you use this type of switches, then make sure the switch to remain turned off while you reset the NodeMCU. Otherwise the booting process will fail. But if you use push buttons, then there is no such limitation. This is a very useful home automation project, and you can also join our Telegram channel Tech Study Cell for more such home automation project ideas. So if you find this video helpful, please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such project. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.